Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to A Paragon Guide. I am Silphin. In this video, we are taking a look at Kwong. So we are taking a look at his skills, abilities, and starter decks for him, doing a beginner's guide for you, and hopefully you can learn something. So ladies and gentlemen, it is in my opinion that Kwong is best suited as a fighter. So open up your selected deck screen, go to starter deck, fighter, attack speed. Depending on your account level, you'll have various others, and then of course your custom decks, but please select your starter deck, fighter, attack, speed. Now, you have to look at your team and see if you are going to jungle. Who is taking a harvester key and who is not. So you can see that this Chimera here is the other jungler and looks like he's not going to do that. So what we are going to do, we're going to go for a health potion, a harvester key, and no, we're not. Okay. Sorry about that. We are going right into So once you have that harvester key, go head on right into the jungle and start your jungling routine. So we can see here that this Chimera has started the red buff, and I'm going to help him just a little bit here get these heroes, those little minions, down. Now, him and I will be sharing the jungle here, and it looks like he got the red jungle just fine, so we can move on from there. I'm going to go to these white camps and start killing them. Now, the very first ability that I recommend if you are jungling like we are is Gift of the Heavens. This is his E ability or his Q on PlayStation 4. And what it does is it gives us a passive. So around our hero here, we are going to get a aura that gives lifesteal to allies. And what that's going to do is enable allies to heal for a portion of the damage that they deal. So here, if I come in and attack here, what it's going to do is this howitzer is going to get lifesteal from all that damage that he does. What it also does, though, is it gives us the ability to... What it does, though, it gives us the ability to sustain against these white minions much easily. So what we can do is kill these minions, but not take so much damage. So that is why we're going for that very first ability. The second ability we got was Judgment of the Heavens, is his Q or his square on PS4. Judgment of the Heavens, what you do is you throw and plant your sword into the ground and you deal 43 physical damage. What it also does is tether the enemy for 1.75 seconds. So here we go, we're gonna come in here and take out this. Oh, but I was unable to get this, the red buff, and we died. Now, what your Judgment of the Heavens is great for is that tethering. So you can tether the enemies for 1.75 seconds, and what I was trying to do there, as you might have seen, was tether that Greystone away from us so that we could instead... So we could instead survive that conflict. So it didn't really work out there, but that's okay. The next card we are going for here is the Brawler's Ward in our third slot, and fill that there. Now at the 3-minute mark, your harvesters will be available for the taking. So right there in the middle of the jungle, you can go ahead and plant those. What you can also do is plant them on the sides, and we'll do that in just a moment, though we have a engagement here in this middle lane that I want to make sure goes in our favor. So we're gonna go here, go on this Kwong, and make sure that he dies. We're gonna try to get this Greystone, but I miss with our Judgment of the Heavens and didn't secure him in place. So as you can see, I'm roaming around the map trying to make sure that we get some kills here, and that is exactly the role that a jungler needs to perform. You need to keep an eye on the minimap and make sure that you rotate to fill lanes that are empty. As you can see, this right lane is empty because the Aegean Scourge went back and needed to get his card power into some cards. So we rotated here. We saw that the Murdoch is not really pushing this lane too hard, so we can definitely go and plant this Harvester on the other side. Now, another job of yours that is very, very important is placing wards in your jungles. So I haven't placed any wards in my jungles. I'm not too worried about the enemy coming into our jungles just yet. So what I am going to do though is try to do something a little bit here in the enemy jungle. But as you can see here, I don't think this Kuang knows that, oh, there we go, and I'm actually using my ultimate here. Oh, and I missed my ultimate. Very unfortunate there. I really needed to make sure that we killed that Kuang, because that would have been a very nice boost of power. So instead of going too far into the enemy jungle, I'm just going to place a ward here right on the inside. Why you want to put that on the inside is because a range hero like this Murdoch will be able to, oh, whoops, wrong button there. Will enable that ward to survive, just because that Kuang won't be, oh, and I misclicked that as well. I did not mean to put out the Q there. Little bit of misplays here, as it is quite the early game so far. A lot of rotation, very nice there. Careful mid lane for sure. So I'm going to try to heal a little bit for... Oh, and I'm low in health, so I have to be careful here. I'm going to pop my right click for some barrier, and no, I just get taken out. Not a good thing, ladies and gentlemen. I should have just backed off, went right back to base, and made sure that I was nice and healthy and not died. So the next card that we are going to go for here is definitely going to be the Amulet of the Veteran. It's going to give us some health here that we really, really need in this early game. And going to be very, very powerful. So Kuang is a fighter, but he definitely needs a little bit of sustain as well, a little bit of tankiness. So here in this Amulet of Veteran, it has a good amount of health that we will definitely get. And we will also get this Adamant's Edge, which has 100 health on it as well. That's all the health here that we can get in this deck, so that we are going to go for those cards, as they are very, very important for Kuang. And the very last ability that we got was Light of the Heavens, his right click, or right trigger on PS4. What it does is it deals 104 physical damage around Kuang's sword wherever it is. So remember that you can, with your Judgment of the Heavens, throw it out. So you can either throw out your sword and then use Judgment of the Heavens, or sorry, Light of the Heavens, to deal damage to the sword while it's out, or when it's in your hands, you can just do that damage around yourself. So you have kind of a ranged ability in the sense. So you can throw out your sword and then use your right click to do kind of a ranged ability. So here we're going to do this, we're going to do this, pull it back, but it looks like this house is not able, oh, but there's that Chimera that I didn't quite notice here come in. So I'm going to try to get away from this, oh, but very nice rotation from everybody involved, able to make that happen. Very nicely done. And I'm actually going to roam a left lane as well. So there is one more Harvester here on the map that you should be aware of. And that is this Harvester right here. That looks like it's taken by the enemy team. I'm placing a ward right there, just because that is a great spot for in order to detect a whole bunch of the enemy camps. Oh, very nicely done. I don't say so myself. Able to throw my sword and then do that damage to that Fengmao with my right. Like as you can see there, you do have basically a ranged ability there, and that's exactly what we used it for. Now, there is, as you saw, that right harvester on the right lane. There is its counterpart here on the left lane. We're just going to attack it, make sure that we can claim this one for our own. So let's watch us steal this camp here from this Fengmao. That's exactly why, ladies and gentlemen, we put that ward here in the jungle, so that we can watch as the enemy team tries to take down some camps and instead turn it around and kill them. So here is this Greystone walking away here. I don't think he notices I'm here, though. Oh, very nice. Very nicely done as he goes away. All right, so we killed that harvester there in the left lane, went and killed that Fengmao in the jungle, and we have to go back and get that harvester down in place. Now, Kuang's ultimate. It's called Fury of the Heavens. It's an AoE damage all around you that is applied after a short burst. For a short little kind of delay, you deal a whole bunch of damage around you and slow the enemy as well. But you also teleport to your sword if it's been thrown out by Judgment of the Heavens. So as you can see, again, you have two abilities that are played around the sword. You can either electrify your sword with Light of the Heavens, or you can teleport to it and deal an AoE around your sword with your ultimate. So you have a bit of kind of play with your ultimate here. It really is quite powerful. I can, for instance, throw it in here, gets a little bit of damage off, but it didn't, in fact, actually do anything there. So we're going to just punish this Greystone a little bit for overextending, and we'll just at least proc his ultimate and come back here and kill this Fengmao. So what I am going to do, though, is just do this into my ultimate, because we're going to hit a couple people here, hopefully able to kill this Fengmao, and I am, and we're going to retreat after this. So I'm going to, right. I thought he was going to engage, because another thing about your right click is it gives you energy and physical armor. So what I wanted to do there was try to, so here I'm going to hold him back, do some damage there, and allow that gadget to kill him. Come on, gadget. There we go. And we could kill that. Oh, but it looks like that Twin Blast was able to get me there. I don't think he actually hit me, just with a little bit of AoE. 9 card power, almost 12 here, will be very, very powerful. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to upgrade this Amulet of the Veteran first. This little bit of health is going to help us right into the end game, stay a little bit alive, a little bit more, and actually work into our passive ability. So once we're done that, we're going to come into here, into the Brawler's Ward, get a Major Strike, and some mana, just because, as you can see here, we do use quite a bit of abilities, and as you can see, we're at 89 mana. If we're able to use our abilities a little bit more, we'll be able to do quite a bit more in these fights. So why does that health work really nicely for Kuang? Well, remember his passive. He gains 15 lifesteal for himself, and it's 30% as effective for AoE attacks. So if you can stay alive a little bit longer and deal more damage in that time, what's going to happen is you're going to get more health back for each attack that you do. So in essence, you're actually kind of giving yourself more health than just, you know, the 800 that we just got on paper. It kind of feeds back into itself there. So as you can see, Kuang is quite the force. one of the most important things for him, I do believe, is making sure that you understand exactly when you can engage and exactly when you should back off. If you know that you can take out the enemy, like this Kwong here, for example, I know that I can. So I'm going to engage and make sure that he does not come out of this alive. So I'm actually going to use my right click here just for a little bit of damage. I'm going to tow him here. Oh, but I missed! And I missed my ultimate! Ladies and gentlemen, that is exactly what you not want to do. Exactly what you not want to do. You, as a jungler, have to make those ganks work. You have to make those ganks work. And I have the red buff, so you have to make those work. If you don't, that is just one. That is a numbers advantage that we now are not going to have. That is the card, more importantly, the card power that I'm not going to have for myself or for my teammates. So that is a very, very big deal. Making sure that you can get those rotations is going to really make those ganks, sorry, is really going to make you successful. If you miss them, that is everything. So I'm going to see this. A Greystone is coming on over here, and I'm going to need some help here. But I'm going to use this for some barrier here. And oh, but he was able to get me half health, so that was a very successful little bit of poke damage there. And we don't have that health potion that we could have gotten there in the early game. So I'm going to wait for my ultimate to come in here. I'm going to hold down this Murdoch, and now that my ultimate's going to be up very soon here, now we can go in and do that very, very nice. I'm going to use my ultimate here to finish him off and hopefully stay alive while we can punish this Greystone just a bit here. I'm going to make sure that maybe our Chimera gets away, so he's tethered to my sword, but not anymore. So now we can punish him. That this red buff is going to really enable us to body block him, so we're going to try to do this. We're going to use our right click for a little bit of energy barrier and physical barrier to reduce that damage that we take, and now we're able to push this right lane. A few misplays, ladies and gentlemen, really could have made some of these engagements go much more in our favor. If I had my ultimate there available when I had that Murdoch tethered, I definitely could have finished him off much quicker and would have definitely been able to turn that engagement around much, much faster. Using your abilities at very key moments is really going to make you a mediocre Kwong or a very good Kwong, sure. So, ladies and gentlemen, 6 card power. We're going to go over here and finish off this Brawler's Ward and get, not get that much mana, so we're just going to get this Major Strike here. The mana is certainly nice, but we can definitely use it better elsewhere. In fact, let's take that out and go into our Wind Carver Blade here, where there's 2 of them, and what we want is one that has more of those kinetics. So you can see here that this has 2 2-point kinetics, and this has 2 2-point strikes. We want this one with that more attack speed. So we're going to go here, put in our 4th slot, and head on out. We're going to actually get a health potion here with that one card, just so that we can utilize all the card power available to us. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, going to come and help out our howitzer here. We do have the red buff once more, and it should be good here for us. So I'm going to try to get out of this Greystone ult, and I will definitely do that. So we're going to actually here focus on this Kwong. Now, versus him and I, should be able to beat him out here, because we do have the red buff, but it looks like he's actually doing a better job here. I'm going to use my ultimate first, try to take him out before he takes me, and now we can come over here and take out this Greystone. I'm going to feign here. Let's see. Oh, but he gets away. Very nicely done. I'm going to chase him down here a little bit. See if he turns around to realize that I am chasing him. But we should be able to, with our Q, get him no problem here. So let's see. There we go, kill him. And I'm going to actually go into the prime orb here and finally get this harvester. So with 6 card power, ladies and gentlemen, going to get a major strike and this kinetic. What this is going to do, give us a great amount of increased damage per second from that attack speed. Makes us hit faster and again apply our basic attack damage more frequently. Always try to come in on the side, ladies and gentlemen, so you can do stuff like this. I'm actually going to engage really hard here because the tower is almost dead, and you can do stuff like that, ladies and gentlemen, like nobody's business. That burst damage potential with Kwong is out of this world, so if you can just make sure that you do a little bit like that, then you can actually do quite a good job. We're going to attack this this inhibitor just a little bit here, and then come on out. Oh, looks like I, for some reason, attacked a hero and the inhibitor attacked me. I'm not sure I exactly did, but that's okay. After this, after fully upgrading this brawler's ward, we're going to go and get the Adamant's Edge. It's our only other source of health here in the starter deck, so we're going to go for the Adamant's Edge and put it in the 5th slot. We want that 100 health. It's going to be better than this crit here, or the Blade of Agora that gives a crit bonus. We don't have crit. We don't need the Blade of Agora then, so that's why we're going for the Adamant's Edge, and then a second Wind Cover Blade here in to replace this health potion. At this point, the health potion restores so little of our health that we're going to put it over here and start upgrading this one. Here, we have the health, we are happy, so we want some of this more kinetic upgrades. And it looks like we were defeated. Great job by the enemy team. Grouping up, taking Orb Prime, barreling down one lane while I was caught out. Got one inhibitor down, but wasn't able to get their core before they killed us. So there you guys have it. There is the build. After that last Wind Carver Blade that we got here, you would have upgraded that. Then you would have had the option of replacing this Brawler's Key. Once you upgrade everything and everything is fully upgraded, you have the option of replacing this Brawler's Key with the Spear of the Writrunner that gives you crit. What that is going to do is give you more of an advantage in the DPS department while eliminating the key that you have to place down those harvesters. In the late game, once you're fully upgraded, harvesters, their relevance starts to go by the wayside. They obviously give you CP experience, card experience over the long term, but since it's in the end game, you're looking for short term rewards. So that is why you want to replace that key with the Spear of the Rift Runner if you feel appropriate. So there you guys have it. There is the thing with Kwong. One thing I didn't get to showcase was placing down your sword while you were going back somewhere on the map, maybe in a lane or so. And then once you are back in base, after you've gotten all your cards, you can use your ultimate to teleport all the way across the map back into lane in an instant. What that does, obviously, eliminates all that travel time, making you get card experience and character experience much, much faster. You know, that you don't have your ultimate, but if you are, say, if you are laning, Kwong definitely can lane, that's for sure, then maybe you don't need your ultimate. You can hold off for 90 seconds while it regenerates. There you guys go. Hopefully you guys found this guide useful. If you follow my instructions here, I think this is the best way to build Kwong. Definitely a fighter. His lifesteal keeps him alive just a little bit more, but you do need that little bit of health, that 800 health on that Amulet of the Veteran, 900 if you include the Staff of the Adamant, just to stay alive just a little bit longer than normal for your lifesteal to really kind of kick into effect. Make sure that you maybe kill a hero, get that advantage, turn a fight around, stuff like that. Please like the video if you like it, dislike if you dislike it, share it with the community, of course, subscribe if you found this content helpful or you simply enjoyed it. Please subscribe so I can do it for you in the future. Until next time, like always, stay optimistic and positive.